Another important topic in tribal India is particularly vulnerable tribal group, okay, PVTG. So this can be asked as a 10 marker, 15 marker, sometimes as a essay type also, but commonly asked 10 to 15 mark, their problems, okay, what are their features, etc. So here we will try to define and understand who are these PVTGs, okay, what is this, why a separate category of name given to these tribals, what are their features, matlab what are the problems that these tribals face, okay, then what the government is doing to address this problem, okay, the schemes related to PVTG, okay. To give a brief background, so tribals as a whole is a vulnerable community. Yes, they are a marginalized community, socio-economically, politically also they are vulnerable. But even among them, Debar Commission in 1960-61, Debar Commission in 1960-61 observed that even within this tribal community, there were certain tribes who were even worst off. Okay, so within the scheduled tribe, there existed large amount of inequality. So there were some tribes who were very backward compared to the other tribes who required lot of or greater attention. So such tribe, okay, required a separate clause and separate effort by the government to address their problem. So this Debar Commission recommended that we should have a subcategory within the tribes of the most vulnerable tribal groups. So from the fourth five-year plan onwards, a subcategory of tribes within the tribe, overall scheduled tribe, a subcategory was created, which was called as primitive tribal group, PTG. But primitive, the word primitive is ethnocentric. Yes, you can call somebody's socio-cultural practice just because it is not according to your ways as primitive. So because it connoted a ethnocentric nature, so therefore the name was renamed, okay, in 2006 this category was renamed as PVTG, particularly vulnerable tribal group. You understood the background, okay. Now coming, so from fourth five-year plan the subcategory was created. Now what is, how do you define, or how, what are the features of this particularly vulnerable tribal group? One, their population should either be declining or stagnant. Their number is either the same or it has been decreasing. They should have low literacy rate compared to other tribal group. They should be practicing pre-agriculture level of technology. That means hunting and gathering, pre-agriculture technology, they should be using that, and they should be economically backward. Such a tribal group can be designated as PVTG. Such tribe identified as PVTG who are socio-economically very, very backward. Okay, the indicators show that they are very backward. They are distributed in 18 states and Andaman and Nicobar Island. Is it understood? So if you talk about the data, as per the 2001 census, there are 75 groups that have been identified as PVTG and having a population of around 27 lakh. The majority of them live in the six states: Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Okay, out of this, Orissa has the largest number of PVTG. So why are they vulnerable? Why are they more vulnerable than the rest of the group? Because loss of their traditional livelihood, habitat and customary resources, right? Because most of them live in the forest and are dependent on the primitive pre-agrarian technology. So therefore they are vulnerable to loss of their livelihood, habitat and customary, right? Because they are poor in education, they have socio-economical backwardness, because of this they have lost their livelihood, their land and resources are being lost because of their backwardness, there is chronic malnutrition, starvation and poor health, that is why their number is deteriorating. They have very small population, if you don't take care of them then they will be lost for ever okay, and they inhabit the most remotest areas of the country, hilly areas, forested area, islands of Andaman and Nicobar Island. If they are not protected, they will be lost forever. The most important groups that are identified even among the PVTG are Shompens. You might have heard about Sentinelis, okay, Jarvas of Andaman and Nicobar Island, the Bondos of Odisha. These are all groups that have been identified in different states which are very much vulnerable. Okay, some of these tribes even have not been included under the scheduled tribes. So that is the problem. Okay, let's see some of the case studies. Okay, some of these tribes are still working as bonded laborers. If you see tribal group of Rajasthan, Saharia in Baran in Rajasthan, they still work as bonded labor by a system which is known as Hali system. They work as agricultural bonded laborers. Similarly, as I told you earlier when we were doing about health and all, Juang tribe in Orissa. So they are also a PVTG. Okay, they are forced to provide labor for repayment of their debt system, which is known as Goti. They have a bonded labor system called as Goti. In spite of presence of law, because lack of education and empowerment, they still are bound by this particular system. Okay, so most of them are forest dwellers. Yes, because they practice pre-agrarian technology, hunting and gathering, depend upon the forest for their livelihood. Over time, this has been declared as reserve forest, protected forest, and their rights have been denied. For example, another example, Baiga. Okay, they have been moved because of the Achanakamar tiger reserves. This is some case studies to understand the gravity of the situation. Then there are other problems also. Some of these tribes have not got scheduled tribe status, so they have been denied reservation. They have been denied other economic benefits available to other tribes. For example, Abuj, Maria, they have been denied this. Not all states, okay, with PVTG have scheduled area. So they don't have a grassroots democratic institution to protect. We saw that fifth scheduled areas will create a Gram Sabha. Yes, provide for Gram Sabha, and this will help in protecting their land from alienation. But many states, okay, which is having PVTG, like Karnataka has PVTG, the Jainu Kuruba, which I told you. So, but their land is yet not protected because there is no provision of scheduled aid. Then they are endangered and at the verge of extinction. Okay, in many states, to ensure that their number increases, for example, state approach of preservation to encourage their population growth, many of these PVTG have been denied sterilization scheme. More problems than the rest of the tribes. So to address this, there is a scheme, a centrally sponsored scheme called as scheme of development of PTG. Okay, so this scheme, initially it was started in 1998-99 as a 100% centrally sponsored scheme. It was restructured in 2008 and it was made more effective. So the aim of the scheme is to promote the socio-economic development of this tribe in a holistic manner. Okay, so by adopting a habitat development approach. See, these are points that you have to remember. It's a centrally sponsored scheme. Okay, and it is habitat approach, holistic development, socio-economic development of tribal. The aim is to improve the quality of the life of the PTGs. Okay, so now anyways, PVTGs, is that okay? So this is applicable for the 75 tribes distributed in the 18 states and one union territory. It is not a rigid scheme, it is a flexible scheme. That means the state and the grassroots level will be involved in planning for the PVTGs. They will plan what is required and they will implement this scheme. So it will be directed on those activities which are very crucial for their survival, protection and development. So for every PVTG, okay, they will come up with a conservation come development plan. Conservation means their number has to be increased. So conservation and at the same time development. So for each of these 75 tribes, A conservation come development plan has to be developed. The existing institutions like your integrated tribal development plan, ITDP or ITDA or tribal research institutions will be involved in planning. What kind of plan? Conservation come development plan will be developed. Okay, the plan will be applicable for 5 years. Okay, so voluntary organization and NGOs will be involved in planning as well as implementation of these schemes, and it's a 100% centrally sponsored scheme. I hope you understood. It is going to be planned for each of the 75 PVTG. Now, in 2015, this scheme was revised. Okay, and it was called as development of particularly vulnerable tribal group from effect from 2015. Again, it is a 100% centrally sponsored scheme, and the activities that will be involved is housing, distribution of land, agricultural development as well as animal husbandry, construction of basic infrastructure like roads, installation of non-conventional source of energy and others. So these activities will be involved in the scheme. Okay, for a comprehensive socio-economic development of PVTG. So again, this is based on conservation cum development plan. Okay, so under this scheme, priority is given to protection and improving their socio-economic indicators like livelihood, nutrition, healthcare, education, etc. Is that understood? So this is the recent improvement in the existing scheme. Okay, so we have discussed what is PVTG, what is their problem, and what is the scheme to address this.